6th standard students, let us start from page number 252, 12.3 proportion. Now we have seen ratio, how we can calculate the ratio. Now proportion. Consider this situation. Raju went to the market to purchase tomatoes. One shopkeeper tells him the cost of tomatoes is rupees 40 for 5 kg. Another shopkeeper gives the cost of a 6 kg for rupees 42. Now what should Raju do? Should he purchase tomatoes from the first shopkeeper or from the second? Will the comparison by taking the difference help him decide? No, because here cost is given for 6 kg and here 5 kg. So think of some way to help him. Discuss with your friends. Now, first we will calculate for 1 kg, then quality wise, practically, and if calculation wise, so cheap price. We will go for cheap price. Now, consider another example. Bhavika has 28 marbles and Winnie has 180 flowers. They want to share these among themselves. Bhavika gave 14 marbles to Winnie and Winnie gave 90 flowers to Bhavika. But Winnie was not satisfied. She felt that she had given more flowers to Bhavika than the marbles given by Bhavika to her. What do you think? Is Winnie correct? To solve this problem, both went to Winnie's mother, Pooja. Pooja explained that out of 20 marbles, Bhavika gave 40 marbles to Winnie. Therefore, ratio half. Out of 28, 14 marbles, Winnie got. So, 14 upon 28, that means 1:2. And out of 180 flowers, Winnie had given 90 flowers to Bhavika. Therefore, ratio is 90:180. That means 1:2. Now you can see here in both the situations, ratio, the value of ratios are same. Since both the ratios are the same, so the distribution is fair. Equally distribution has been done. Two friends, Ashma and Pankhuri, went to market to purchase hair clips. They purchased 20 hair clips for 30 rupees and Ashma gave rupees 12 and Pankhuri gave rupees 18. After they came back home, Ashma asked Pankhuri to give 10 hair clips to her. But Pankhuri said, since I have given more money, so I should get more clips. You should get 8 hair clips and I should get 12. Can you tell who is correct, Ashma or Pankhuri? Why? Ratio of money given by Ashma to the money given by Pankhuri. So Ashma paid 12 and Pankhuri paid 18. So 12:18, that means 2:3. 12 upon 18. So 6 2 are 12, 6 3 are 18. According to Ashma's suggestion, the ratio of the number of hair clips for Ashma to the number of hair clips for Pankhuri, 10:10, that means 1:1. According to Pankhuri's suggestion, the ratio of the number of hair clips for Ashma to the number of hair clips for Pankhuri, 8:12. 4 2 are 8, 4 3 are 12. So money distribution. They paid money according to this ratio. So hair clips also they both will get in this ratio. Here if equally distribution will be there, then Ashma gave 12 rupees and Pankhuri gave. Ashma asked Pankhuri to give 10 hair clips to her. Pankhuri said, since I have given more money, so I should get more clips. You should get 8 hair clips and I should get 12. So here you can see 8:12, 2:3. Now notice that according to Ashma's distribution, ratio of hair clips and the ratio of money given by them is not same. But according to Pankhuri's distribution, the two ratios are the same. Hence, we can say that the Pankhuri's distribution is correct. Sharing a ratio means something. Consider the following examples. Raju purchased 3 pens for rupees 15 and Anu purchased 10 pens for rupees 50. Whose pens are more expensive? Ratio of number of pens purchased by Raju to the number of pens purchased by Anu, 3:10. Ratio of their cost, 15:50. 5 threes are 15, 5 tens are 50. So 3:10. So both the ratios you can see here are equal. So we can say that therefore the pens were purchased for the same price by both. And you can see the cost of one pen, 5. And here also the cost of one pen is 5. 50 divided by 10, here 15 divided by 3. So, same price they both have purchased the pen. Now, next. Rahim sells 2 kg of apples for rupees 180. And Roshan sells 4 kg of apples for rupees 360. Whose apples are more expensive? Ratio of the weight of apples, 2:4. 2 upon 4, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. Ratio of their cost, rupees 180, rupees 360. So 180, 1s are 180, and 180, 2s are 360. So 1:2. So the ratio of weight of apples is equal to ratio of their cost. So same price. Since both the ratios are equal, hence we say that they are in proportion. If both the ratios are equal, then we will tell all the 4 quantities are in proportion. They are selling apples at the same rate. And if by simple method, if you will find the cost of 1 kg of apple, rupees 90, and here 4 kg of apple, and then you will calculate here also for 1 kg of apple, you will get 90. If 2 ratios are equal, we say that they are in proportion and use symbol this 4 dots in the square form. So it is the symbol of proportion or equal to equate the 2 ratios. For the first example, we can say that 3, 10, 15 and 50 are in proportion, which is written as this and is read as 3:10 as 15:50, or it is written 3:10 is equal to 15:50. In place of proportion, we can use equal sign. For the second example, we can say that 2, 4, 180, 360 are in proportion, which is written as 2:4 as 180:360 and is read as 2:4 as 180:360. Okay. Let us consider another example. A man travels 35 km in 2 hours with the same speed. Would he be able to travel 70 km in 4 hours? Now, ratio of the two distances traveled by the man is 35:70. That means 35 ones are 35, 35 twos are 70. And the ratio of the time taken to cover these distances is 2:4. That means 2 upon 4, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 1:2. Here the two ratios are equal, that is 35:70 as 2:4. Therefore, we can say that the four numbers 35, 70, 2 and 4 are in proportion. Hence, we can write it as 35:70 as 2:4 and read it as 35:270 as 2:4. Hence, he can travel 70 km in 4 hours with that speed. Now, consider this example. Now consider this example. Cost of 2 kg of apples is rupees 180 and 5 kg watermelon cost rupees 45. Now ratio of the weight of apples to the weight of watermelon 2:5. And ratio of the cost of apples to the cost of watermelon is 180:45. That means 45 ones are 45, 45 2s are 90, 45 3s are 45, 4s are 180. So 4:1. Here the two ratios 2:5 and 180:45 are not equal. 2:5, 4:1. So we can say that 2:5 not equal to 180:45, or we can say that four quantities 2, 5, 180 and 45 are not in proportion. If two ratios are not equal, then we say that they are not in proportion. In a statement of proportion, the four quantities involved when taken in order are known as respective terms. First and fourth terms are known as extreme terms. Second and third terms are known as middle terms. For example, extreme terms and middle terms. 35, 70, 2, 4 are the four terms. 35 and 4 are the extreme terms. 70 and 2 are middle terms. Now, illustration you will solve. Now, children, try this. Check whether the given ratios are equal, that is, they are in proportion. If yes, then write them in the proper form. So 1:5 and 3:15. Orally, I am explaining here. 1:5 as it is. Now 3:15, that means 3 upon 15, 3 ones are 3, 3 fives are 15, 1 upon 5, that means 1:5. So both the ratios are equal, so you will write 1:5 proportion. That means this sign you will use. Which sign? This sign. 1:5 proportion to 3:15. Now 2:9 as it is, and here you will divide this. 9 2s are 18, 9 9s are 81, 18 upon 81. So you will get 9 2s are 9 9s are 2:9 you are getting. So they are also in proportion. Now 15 upon 45, 15 ones are 15, 15 3s are 45, that means 1:3. And here 5 ones are 5, 5 5s are 25. Both the ratios are not equal, so they are not in proportion. So how you will write? They are not in proportion. This. And 4:12 and 9:27. So 4:12, that means 4 ones are 4, 4 3s are 12, 9 ones are 9, 9 3s are 27. So both the ratios are equal, so they are in proportion. 10 rupees 10 to rupees 15 and 4 to 6. So 10 upon 15, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 2:3, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2:3. So they are also in proportion. Now whatever I am telling you, you will solve in the rough notebook, so you will get proper idea. Now exercise 12.2. Determine if the following are in proportion. 15 45 40 120. Now see here, given numbers are 15 45 40 120. Now 15:45, that means 15 upon 45, 15 ones are 15, 15 3s are 45. So 1 upon 3, 1:3. 40 upon 120, 0 cancelled by 0, 4 1s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 1 upon 3, that means 1:3. Both the ratios are equal, so 15:45 proportion to 40:120. Same way you will solve B, C, D, E, F. If you have any query, you can ask me. Write true, T or false, F against each of the following statements. Same way you will solve this. If proportions, rough work, okay, it is you will do in the rough work. And if both the ratios are equal, then true, and both the ratios are not equal, then false. Now I am solving for you E and F, how you will do rough work. Okay, now E, 5.2:3.9, proportion is given as 3:4. Now we will check it is false or true. 5.2 upon 3.9, before 1 digit decimal, before 1 digit decimal, so we can cancel. So 52 upon 39, 52 upon 39, that means 13 4s are 52 and 13 3s are 39. So 4 upon 3, that means 4:3. So 4:3 is not equal to 3:4. So this statement is false. Now here 0.9:0.36 proportion sign is there. 10:4. So 0.9. After decimal, one digit. So we will delete the decimal and after one digit. So in the denominator, we will put 10. And after decimal here, two digits. So in the numerator, we will put 20. So 0 cancel by 0, 90/36. So we can cancel this. 9 ones are 9, 0 as it is, 9 fours are 36. Again by 2, 2 fives are 10, 2 twos are 4, 5/2, 5 is 2. Then next, 10:4, 2 fives are and 2 twos are, 5 is 2. Both the ratios are equal, so this is true. In this way you will solve rough work, and then directly in the CW only false, true, true, false you will write. Now question number 3, are the following statements true? 40% is to 200% is equal rupees 15 is to rupees 75. You will do B. I am solving for you. This you will solve, this you will solve, this you will solve. So I am solving for you same way. If statements true are there too, so true false, true false you will do. In this way you will do in the CW notebook. So I am solving for you this one. Now see here, 7.5 liter is to 15 liter. 7.5/15, after decimal one digit is there, so in the denominator we will put 10. That means 75/150. So 75, 25 threes are 75, and 25 sixes are 150. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 1/2 1:2. Now 5 kg is to 10 kg, so 5/10, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 1/2 1:2. So this statement is true. So in this way you will solve in the CW notebook. Okay, now question 4, determine if the following ratios form a proportion. Also write the middle terms and extreme terms where the ratios form a proportion. So I am solving for you first one. Now see here, 25 centimeter is to 1 meter and rupees 40 is to rupees 160. Now you can see in the first ratio units are not same. So we will write again, 25 centimeter is to 100 centimeter, because in 1 meter 100 centimeter is there, and rupees 40 is to rupees 160. Now you can see units are same. Now extreme terms, 25 and 160. Now we will check the product of these terms. So 25 zeros are 25 and 25 sixes are 150. Now middle terms is 100 and 40. So 100 into 40, 4000. You can see here product of extreme terms and product of middle terms are not equal. So we will write product of extreme terms not equal to product of middle terms. So 25 centimeter is to 1 meter and rupees 40 is to rupees 160 are not in proportion. Okay, same way you will solve second and third. And here 2.5 liter and milliliter, so you will change into milliliter. 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliter, so 2.5 into 1000. Okay, you will change this and solve. So here 12.2 is finished. And if you are having any query, you can ask me.